3 to 4 years overdue, well, no more than 3 years overdue to do a kale chip video. So I'm going to teach you all how to make kale chips if you haven't made them before. It is the most wonderful way to eat your greens. So this is what the kale that I buy looks like. I believe it's curly kale because it looks kind of like parsley on the edges. And I get it for $1 a pound at Harris Teeter. It's local from the Mid-Atlantic region, which is awesome. But you can get it in bunches too, and it's more expensive that way. So what I do is I take it out of the bag like this, and then you can see I've already prepared some in this fashion. And I just tear the kale off the stalks into, into what I hope will be little chip-sized pieces like this. And then I come over to my salad spinner, and I fill this with water and just kind of shake around, massage it like that, and, this part is very important. You would like to make sure that it's very, very dry, because if it's at all wet, you will actually steam the kale instead of crisp it up. So, give it a really, really good spin and maybe not pack this, super tight. However, I mean, if it's going to have a little wetness on it, that's fine. You just don't want it to be dripping. So if you don't have a salad spinner, then you want to make sure you use, like, a ton of paper towels and whatnot to get it very dry. You just want to use a colander. So I usually spin it twice, like so. And then I have a big cookie sheet, and I think this might require two of them. And I use some cooking spray to spray the bottom, like so, and then you just kind of take it like this and put it out on your sheet. And I usually do it about 350 degrees, but if you have other things in your oven, then that's fine. And I usually spray the kale a little bit, like so. And we also think that if you don't crowd your pan too much, that you get a better crisp on the edges. And my hands are kind of wet, but I usually will take some kosher salt like this and sprinkle it on. You can do basically any flavor that you want. Nutritional yeast, garlic powder, cinnamon, chili powder, anything that you want. So I'm going to put these in the oven for about 12 or so minutes, and we'll get you back with an update when that when they get nice and crispy. You know they're done when the edges are crispy and you shake the pan and it goes shuk, shuk, shuk. Let's see. So the edges are crispy. Let's listen. Oh, that means they're done. You can tell that some of these are really crispy, and some of them in the middle are a little bit more wilted, but that's just the, you know, that's just how kale chips work. So I would like to show you the noise that a kale chip makes when you come on in close.
Never eat on camera.
See, it's a chip. At least I didn't eat it Alton Brown style. Oh, it's a chip. Oh, oh.